great pleasure that I present to you Glenn Brown, who will be doing our homily this morning. Glenn, thanks for being here. Morning.
Can everyone hear me okay?
Yes.
Okay, I just wanted to make sure. My name is Glenn Brown. I am a senior at J.J. Pierce High School, and I'm honored to be able to give you all the sermon today. Before I start, though, I'd like to answer a few questions that I get asked all the time here. No, I'm not 7 feet tall. I sit solidly at 6'3". Yes, I'm still growing, and I will throughout college, and probably until I graduate. And yeah, my dad did pass on some pretty decent genes. Joining Epiphany has been the single most important decision in my religious career. Not only has it given me numerous friends and memories that I will cherish for the rest of my life, but it has given me the realization that I have a personal relationship with God. Many of y'all know Betsy as Mother Betsy, but to me, she's just Betsy. She, along with Gardner, the Tansy family, the Van Gundy family, and my own family were a part of my upbringing into the church, and I could not be more thankful for them. When Betsy started her quest to become a priest, my family was religious, but we didn't go to church every Sunday. But, yeah. When she got the job at Epiphany, she invited my whole family to attend her first service, so of course we went. At the time, though, I was only about 9 years old, and I didn't really understand it. Then, after that one service, I still didn't understand it. But after a couple of years of actually paying attention during church, during Sunday school, and during youth group, it finally clicked. I realized that God was awesome. God loved me. He was always there for me to talk to. He was always there to help me throughout whatever I was going through. But that's not to say that he doesn't work in mysterious ways. In the recent past, I found myself between a rock and a hard place. I could either lose all of my friends that I'd come so close to, or go along a path that I didn't truly believe. My personal faith no longer lined up with those of my friends. I loved my friends and I wanted to stay with them, but I couldn't just abandon my faith. This is the most difficult decision in my faith journey so far. I had to lose some of my best friends so that I could further my relationship with God. Before this happened, I had a great relationship with God. I couldn't complain. But after this, I just felt like I had jumped a bridge. Through him, I realized that even though I'd lost some of my best friends, I had gained something even greater than friends. I had gained a relationship with the greatest father of all time. During this time, John chapter 15, the Lord says, "I did not say these things to you from the beginning because I was with you." This verse was very important to me during this time. It means that, to me, it means that the answers were not given to you. I had to figure out everything out for myself over the course of about 4 or 5 months. And once I finally realized it, at the end, it was so much more special to me than it ever could have possibly been if the answer was just given to me. Once I figured things out for myself, I was much happier with my life and the way things were going. I couldn't be more amazed about how such a difficult situation could have ended out in such a great outcome. Our gospel today, John chapter 16, verse 7, we see a glimpse of Jesus talking to his disciples about his departure and then sending the Holy Spirit in his place. I forgot my leaflet, but to sum it up, it said, "When I am with you, the advocate will not come, but once I am gone, the advocate will come to you." Which means that even though you don't have a physical and tangible relationship with Jesus, you will always have the Holy Spirit in your heart and in your soul. Epiphany is one of my favorite places on the earth, and I could not be any more thankful for the people who brought me here and who helped me along. What I learned here, though, I can always take with me. I know that through my baptism and through my confirmation, I have been given the Holy Spirit to guide me through the rest of my life. Paul says in Romans 5, verse 5, that God's love has been poured into our hearts through the Holy Spirit that has been given to us. The Holy Spirit is with us wherever we go and is always there for us to share and to keep to ourselves or not. Whatever you choose to do with it, it's there for you. On this, the Feast of Pentecost, all of us celebrate the Holy Spirit in our lives and in our church. All of us are called to share God's love in a world that needs it so desperately right now. So as Father Bill will say, may it be so. Amen.